Building end-to-end solution might not be trivial. If you're a Vision AI expert, delivering a turnkey solution to a customer might be a bit tricky. Azure IoT Central to the rescue, as well as IoT Edge in that case. Yusuf from DDI Lab is here to share his experience leveraging IoT Central, IoT Edge to implement Vision AI solutions for their customers. That's today on the IoT Show. Hi, everyone. You're watching the IoT Show. Thanks for tuning in. My name is Olivier. I'll be your host today. And today we'll talk about a very interesting solution, putting together Vision AI and IoT Central to deliver new ways of dealing with workflows. And for that, we have Yusuf. Yusuf, how are you?
Hi, Olivier. I'm good. Thanks. Yourself?
I'm great. I'm fantastic. And, you know, I'm not super healthy today, but that's fine. You know, we'll make it work. How about you?
Yeah, I'm doing well. It's quite early this morning, but everything's going great.
Where are you calling from?
I'm actually based in Sri Lanka, but our company is an Australian company located in Sydney.
Okay. Well, yeah. What is that company and what is it that you guys are doing?
Yeah, so it's DDI Labs. We are an AI startup and we use computer vision to drive data decisions. So we work with various different government agencies and private companies to unlock the full potential of video data.
Nice. Yep. So here you came to show us one of your solutions that really highlights, you know, Vision AI and how it can enhance this kind of workflows in people's life, you know, and enhancing the workflows, but like simplifying operators' life and so on. We'll see that in a second. And you're leveraging Azure IoT Central, and we'll look at that as well. So tell me about the solution you're going to show today.
Yeah, exactly. So the little bit of background on the customer. So yep. International Tower Sydney is a large commercial precinct managed by JLL, and they've got three loading docks which manage around 350 to 400 deliveries per day, as well as casual vehicles. Yeah. So the problem they had was the site was managed by three full-time guards for each section of the dock. And then there was a dock master on top of that had to kind of like validate every single booking. So tasks that included updating booking statuses manually, checking the vehicle height, opening the boom gate, making sure there are available car spaces. So there was quite a few basically mundane tasks that the guards had to do. So we at DDI found an opportunity here to reuse the existing CCTV cameras on site to automate these tasks. Okay. And now the system we built now enables full automation of valid bookings, automated boom gate access on whitelisted vehicles, a custom dashboard that allows the dock master to see the vehicle height as it enters, all the available bays, and which vehicle is parked in a given bay in just a matter of clicks.
Nice. And your solution, we discussed that when we were preparing, is not about replacing the humans. It's really about, you know, empowering them to be more efficient, to have less prone errors happening. So it's really not about replacing humans. It's really about amplifying, augmenting the work they can do, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So the key success was that it now allows the dock master and the guards to do more complex tasks and make efficiently use their time. Yeah.
Yeah. Make their work more interesting.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Awesome. So show me a bit about the solution. We'll talk about the details and what's under the hoods after.
Yeah. Excellent. So as you can see on the screen here, we've got a LPR camera on entry. And this captures a license plate recognition of the vehicle, and this drives the automation process. Okay. We've also developed a custom Flutter application that sits on a tablet on this powder coater stand here, and it will be used to scan the booking of the driver and validate with the existing booking system on site. So as the vehicle drives... Yep, sorry.
No, go ahead. I'm just nodding, like it.
As the vehicle drives through, the driver would scan the QR code. And while it's validating the bookings, the LPR camera will also capture the license plate. So you should be able to see that here.
So that's a real-time feed right now, right? So you didn't even plan that.
Exactly, yeah. So the vehicle entered, yeah. And then once the vehicle enters on site, our Vision AI kicks in.
Okay.
So you can see the driver coming in, scanning the booking. It's validating the booking. Or it's having a chat.
Also having a chat. Offering a coffee. That's it, buddy.
But that's yeah, cool. So as the booking got accepted, the boom gate opened, and then the vehicle entered.
Got it.
So this is our Vision AI. As you can see, it's running on all the cameras on the dock that's looking at the parking bay. So we use a YOLO-based inference engine. We've done quite a bit of local training as well to improve that accuracy. And because we know the camera ID and we can geomap the bay, we're able to identify which bay ID is looking at what camera. So as a vehicle moves from one camera to the next and parks at a given bay, we know exactly which bay that is.
And you were saying you're reusing the existing CCTV infrastructure, so you didn't even have to deploy a new set of cameras, right?
Exactly. So that's one of the key features of our solution, is that we try to minimize the cost for our customer, and when and where possible, we try to use existing infrastructure.
And the inferencing happens on site as well, right? So you have a box. Is it only one box that does inferencing for all these cameras at once?
Yeah, so we've got one server, a dedicated server on site, and that basically runs this full solution. So it's dedicated for our solution. Yeah.
Okay, awesome. So it's pretty lightweight, I would say, in terms of installation.
Definitely, yeah.
Okay.
So as the vehicle comes in, basically our tracker would assign it a tracking ID, and this will allow us to track it from one camera field to the next. So as it moves on from a camera frame, we can pass the tracking ID onwards. And that's how we're able to track the vehicle across the whole loading dock.
Okay.
Yep. And then finally, our custom dashboard. So as you can see, this is a real-time view the dock master sees. And they can easily identify what bays are available and which are occupied, as this is the same layout of the dock they have. So visually, it's easy to understand for them.
Mm-hmm.
They can click on a bay.
I guess previously they were using like a physical map, and they were just like keeping tabs on who's where, or just a table on a paper or something like that, right?
Yeah, so they had guards on site that would walk around and basically check the vehicles that were parked, because it's quite a large dock. So, quite often people don't actually park on the bay they are given, so it's hard to track as well.
Got it. Okay, so like you just hover and you have the license plate. That shows up, right?
Yeah, so the dock master can easily just click on a bay, see the plate. If it's got a booking attached to it, they got the booking ID here as well. So they can easily check. So if it's a purple, it means the vehicle has overstayed its booking. So they can easily take action based on the color codes of the tiles.
Got it.
And on top here, we're showing kind of like an overview. So they know, okay, dock one is pretty much almost full. So when the next vehicle comes, we'll send them to dock two and so forth.
Love it. Love it.
We've added a couple of other features as well on this dashboard. One is the ability to whitelist and blacklist vehicles. Okay. So for example, if a whitelisted vehicle does come in, the boom gate would just open straight away, allowing the vehicle in. Mm-hmm. And if a blacklisted vehicle comes in, an alert will pop up, and then the dock master can take the relevant actions after that.
Okay.
And
I would say that from here on, the interesting thing is that scenarios are kind of like limitless, because you have all the data, and then the scenario basically is usually adapted to your customers, right? So you will adapt your solution to the customer needs and scenarios here, right?
Exactly. That's the beauty of it, because we sort of develop step by step. So we've added a lot more features now than we currently did at the beginning.
Okay.
So it's really easy, because we kind of install them in certain microservice modules. Okay. So as we develop new features, we just have to add on another module and remove a module or stuff like that. Yeah.
Got it. So the title of the video mentions Azure IoT Central. So tell us, how are you using, because here we're not seeing IoT Central for now, right? So how are you as DDI Labs leveraging and using IoT Central in this case?
That's an excellent question. So as you can see, a solution like this has a lot of different software, hardware components that kind of need to get integrated together.
Yeah.
And we are currently using IoT Central now as a way of managing this whole solution. So internally for us as DDI Labs to manage, monitor the solution, make sure it's running smoothly. That is our core feature of IoT Central. So I'll just share with you the IoT Central dashboard.
Okay, let's look at that.
So as you can see, this is the IoT Central dashboard. We've got various different device template versionings. And this is actually a real good benefit of using IoT Central. As I told you, initially, we did not have the full solution. We added features in step by step. Mm-hmm. So this allowed us to create a new version and update it to the next version, test it. If things didn't work out, we could easily migrate it back down to the previous version. So we had minimal downtime in the system. So this allowed us to continuously develop and then make changes. This is actually the device.
And so you're leveraging all the features of IoT Central in terms of managing the IoT Edge devices, because IoT Edge is what's powering the server you were mentioning earlier, right?
Exactly. So our server is running IoT Edge, and that's kind of sending the data upstream to IoT Central. So
you can from that dashboard, you can say, hey, I want to deploy a new model for, you know, recognizing new type of vehicle or, you know, optimizing my models, right? Because they're YOLO ones, but you can definitely retrain them at will. And then you can, from here on IoT Central, with your, let's say, administrator view, you can now deploy the new version of a model onto these boxes that are out there.
Exactly. So when there's a new version released or a different model that we want to use, we can easily upload it from IoT Central. So we just put in the path, install it on the server, and then run it from there. Yeah.
Got it. And are you using the multi-tenancy features, or you could eventually, right? Because you have different customers with similar solution, you can eventually manage their boxes, you know, in the same interface using multi-tenancy support in a form of organizations in IoT Central.
Exactly. At this point, we are not actually using that. Okay. So we've been creating a new app with a new resource group for each customer, just mm-hmm. for privacy and data that the resources are not shared. But that's something we definitely have been using in smaller projects. So not these larger projects.
Got it. Interesting. And you did show us a, you wanted to show me a bit more about the devices, right?
No, go ahead. That's fine.
I wanted to ask you about the extensibility. So we saw a custom map and UI that the doc master will be using that is not an IoT Central UI. That's something that is delivered for the customer in the form of a web page. They have all login for the customer, for their personnel, I guess. Did you leverage some of the extensibility features of IoT Central for that?
Exactly. So our whole project initially started with the end dashboard being on IoT Central.
Okay.
As you can see, we've created custom dashboard using IoT Central. So this is the overview tab, and then this is the map. So as you can see visually, this was hard for the doc master to identify, hey, where is bay one in terms of my loading dock?
Yeah.
So this is where we kind of reached a limitation for IoT Central. So what we're doing now is we are basically exporting the data from IoT Central itself to our custom dashboard. So all the data is coming from our edge device to IoT Central and then getting pushed out to our custom dashboard.
Got it. So I don't know if it's an easy thing to estimate right now like that, but would you say that IoT Central saved you a lot of developing time? Because at the end of the day, it's about managing the connectivity securely to the devices, gathering the data, managing the runtimes for IoT Edge as well as the models running on them. And you're doing the maintenance for the customers of the IoT Edge runtime and the models, right? So all of that from IoT Central, I would guess, saved you a lot of time.
A lot. Yeah. It's so easy now because basically from this portal, we can monitor each module. And as you mm-hmm. can see, we have various different modules here for different parts of the solution. We can view the logs, we can restart the modules, we can run commands. We've also exporting the system connectivity events. So if there is an issue, actually last week we had an issue where the internet had gone off and the system was offline. We got an alert straight away saying, hey, something's wrong, investigate this. And then we took action.
Nice.
Yes. So IoT Central has made things a lot easier for us. And also the fact of replicating this exact solution in another site or similar solution in another site using IoT Central, it's only a few steps away. We just have to create a new device, make sure the cameras obviously are configured and whatnot. But on the software side of it, it won't take long to replicate the solution. And also develop other solutions. So we've built different kinds of solutions using similar modules. Okay. So because the modules are already there, it's not hard for us to just pick a few modules and build another solution completely. So,
yeah. And what kind of other solutions? Because you're like, when you look at your website, DDI Labs is really about vision AI, right? So that's your domain of expertise. IoT Central takes care of all the device management and so on. And then you export the data to customize the solution. So your realm is vision AI. What kind of scenarios you guys are leveraging vision AI for these days?
So another big project important in Australia is chain of responsibility. So it's okay. A course check. So what we do is we basically ensure any vehicle coming on site is fully registered and meets all the compliances for that site. Mm-hmm. If not, we do raise alerts to the guard at the entrance to, hey, either not allow this vehicle on site or to verify that they've actually purchased a new registration and it's just not updated in the system yet. So that's another big project. And smaller ones like people counting at licensed venues. So because of once COVID hit, actually, there was a lot of capacity restrictions and number of people in a certain area. So what we did was we were basically installed a people counting system on the existing cameras on site, and we were able to count the occupancy for the customers. Yeah.
Brilliant. Brilliant. I like the way you're making real all these fake demos we used to have when we started talking about vision AI. They are real scenarios, and you guys are delivering that to your customers. That's brilliant. I love it.
Thanks. Thank you.
Awesome. Well, Yusuf, thanks a lot for joining the show today. If people want to learn more about DDI Labs and your solutions, they can go to this link below, ak.ms/itshow/DDI Labs. Thanks for your time, Yusuf, once again.
Thanks a lot, Oliver. Have a good one.
Okay. Have a good one, everyone. Bye.